how was teaching back in the South? Because all I know is California curriculum. Right. You know what I'm talking about?
Right. Let me tell you something. Right. When I went to school, this is going to sound crazy, but when I went to school, we got paddled by the principal. The teachers whooped us.
Paddled on the hand or
the
butt?
No. The principal could paddle you three times with a paddle. The teachers could hit you on the hand with a ruler. It was a part of the system of school. I promise you, it was normal. Wow. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. That's how you but know what you're
I'm going to tell you this, though. We was well-mannered. We would never say, I would never talk to an adult and not say, yes, ma'am, or yes, sir. You feel what I'm saying? Never. Now, you look at it now, like, oh, I would never. But in the South, the mentality of it takes a village to raise a child, they really live by that. Mm. You know what I'm saying? When I would play outside in the neighborhood, it didn't matter if my mother saw me. If the neighbor saw me, I had to worry about that. Because Mr. Odell down the block, if he see me acting up, he going to whoop my ass. Right. And he going to tell my mom. and then she going to whoop me again. Right. No, she going to whoop me again.
That's crazy.
For even embarrassing her to make him have to whoop me. But that's how the South was.
The South. Wow.
You feel me? That's how I was raised. You know, my whole family. So, damn, I don't know if I should tell this part now or later. This shit crazy. So, look.
He enjoying himself, bro. It's your birthday, bro.
I'm
going to
tell you. So, look.
Take a sip. We
so
solid.
So, in Morin Sport, right, my grandfather had his 2 acres, right? But a little bit down the road, I'm going to say about 2 miles, it was a road that's called a Charity Phillips road. And it went to what's called the Phillip Farm.
Okay.
Now, my grandfather's name is Robert Phillips. That's my family's name.
Okay.
My last name, Jackson. I'm not related to any Jacksons. I have that last name because of the man who...
You live with the Phillips.
Yeah. Right, feel me? Phillips. But yes, the Jacksons, I'm not related to at all. Right. It's just I took that last name because my mother was married to my sister's father. Mm-hmm. And in the South, even if a man don't sign your birth certificate, you're going to take his last name and everything. Mm. So I took his last name.
Gotcha.
Even though he was a nigga that wanted me dead, I had to take his last name.
Gotcha.
But down the road was 40 acres. And it was called the Phillip Farm, because that's my family's name. And my great-great-grandparents was a part of one of the first secret societies formed by black former slaves.
Wow.
Okay. It's called the Mosaic Templars of America. It was formed in 1883.
How long have you known this?
I found this out Tuesday.
Oh, wow. Recent.
Tuesday.
Okay.
Let me tell you why I found out Tuesday. Because I took this whole week to sit and meditate and reflect and extract whatever it was I needed to know before this podcast.
Right.
Feel me? I do this with everything. Okay. So I know whatever I need to know, I'm going to know if I go looking for it. If I ever would have... Because see, every time I went to my grandmother's gravesite, my great-great-great-grandmother's gravesite, she's buried next to my grandfather, I would see that symbol. I never knew what it meant.
Right.
But I knew that the 40 acres that we lived on,
wow,
that road was in her name.
That's awesome.
And I lived on that land at one point.
So finding out this information, how did you feel? Like,
listen, I'm still dealing with that.
Right. Okay.
You feel me? This has been a crazy week.
I feel you. It's eye-opening.
The Mosaic Templars of America was formed in 1883. Now, my grandfather, who I keep telling you about that raised me, now this is my great-grandfather, all right? He was 74 when I was born. This was his grandmother. So she taught him everything. You feel me? Now, the point of this society was to help form businesses for people of color, mm-hmm. a hospital, a school. I'm talking about in the late 1800s. Mm-hmm. My family, my bloodline was my grandma. I could, you know what I'm saying? But I never understood this history. You feel me? Now, what's crazy is this is what I do now.
Okay.
I didn't even know this until Tuesday. You know what I'm saying? So, my grandfather...